heartbreak, Monarch understands Meghan Markle and Harry's journey for normal life. Queen Elizabeth II understood Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's journey for an ordinary life after experience itself or disconnected from it. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex announced their intention to live between England and North America in January after having issued a bombshell statement on their Instagram account in which they detailed their desire to carve out a new role for themselves in the royal family. However, he said it seems like this idea it could have lived abroad in Commonwealth came from the Queen. And when she realized that things were not going well, she looked back to the time she and Prince Philip spent in Malta before she became the Queen, and what a wonderful time that was to live a little bell. Equally everyone a brethren. And the Queen wanted to offer both honor and responsibility to the couple by handing them some role in the beloved British Commonwealth nations, a highly personal token of trust. The Queen and Prince Philip lived in Malta between 1949 and 1959 for a sabbatical year in Africa, during which they could combine their work on the Commonwealth with humanitarian efforts. Mr. Lacey claimed that the Queen herself had discussed plans with senior as to allow Duke and Duchess of Sussex to temporarily live abroad, speaking to African continent. Appearing on ITV documentary Harry and Meghan, African Journey, Prince Harry said, "I don't know where we could live in Africa at the moment, you know. We just come from Cape Town. It could be an amazing place for us to be able to base ourselves, and of course it's good. We live in Africa. Then that's sweet to Canada because Meghan had all her links there." In the book Battle of Brothers, Mr. Lacey wrote, "The big idea was to get Harry and Meghan out of the country for a business to express.co.uk. This was said Mona, having lived a few months of ordinary life as a newlywed with Prince Philip, was keen to allow Meghan and Harry to learn what the Duke was stationed there as a neighbor official. The life on the island came abruptly to an end after the death of King George VI in 1952. Prince Harry himself spoke about the possibility to live in South Africa during the last leg of a successful tour, the royal expert said. The Queen was keen to help Meghan and Harry experience as life as normal as possible in their early years of marriage, according to the royal expert Robert Lacey. The royal commentator recalled reports published in the summer of 2019, which alerted that Meghan and Prince Harry were preparing a half-and-half-out solution they proposed was not accepted by the Queen, Prince William, and Prince Charles. Following a meeting between three royals and Prince Harry at Sandringham, the Sussexes decided to step down as senior royals, relinquish the use of HRH stars as well as the word royal in the first brand normal life. She understood that journey for ordinary life, so it seems like she's the one who suggested this, and she set up a little group of people with Sir Christopher, Jade, and Sir David Manning to work on this. The idea was originally that perhaps with all the problems that going on there, I don't see how we able to make as much difference as we want without the issues and the judgment of how we could be those surroundings. I think it's a very hard place to live when you know that what's going on and when you're again sightly and Sussex royal. The couple who officially stood down from the public duties in late March now live in California, where they have bought a home to share with their firstborn Archie.